Hello, everyone, and welcome to our monthly APTAT Assistive Technology webinar. And this month, we are welcoming you to APTAT. This is a re-recording from our session that we had on Tuesday, October 24th, 2023. We had a little bit of trouble with the captioning covering up our slides, and we also wanted to make sure that we left captioning as an available option for people and not burned in as open captions. So we decided it was best for us to just re-record this portion of the webinar series. So to get started, we have slides for you if you wish to grab onto those, and we do encourage that. We have a lot of resources for you to click on. So it is bit.ly/welcomeaptat. So it's going to be a capital W for welcome, and then all capital letters, APTAT. That will take you to a Google file. However, we will have in the YouTube description not only this link, but a link that will take you to a PDF copy of those slides as well. So what's our agenda for today? Well, we're going to first talk about what the Assistive Technology Act is exactly and what its purpose is. Next, we're going to talk about the services that we provide here at APTAT. Next, we'll review how to request loans, demos, and trainings. And then lastly, we're going to show you some highlights of our recently acquired assistive technology that we're really excited. We want to make sure people know about it so they can borrow it, get their hands on it. All right, so the Alabama Assistive Technology Act program, also known as Accessing Potential Through Assistive Technology. So if you are seeing this logo out and about, that is us. This is our crew over here. So we are currently staffed with myself. I am Jessica McKay, the Assistive Technology Specialist. Ashley McElroy is our director of the program. And then in this picture, not only do you see Ashley and I, but you'll see several contractors and partners that we work with to help this program get up and running. So either through reviews or inventory, helping us with trainings and demonstrations. So down at the bottom right, we have McCartney. She's actually wearing our Glass House mouse. So it's a headset that you wear, just almost like a set of glasses, but there's a little bar that your computer is reading that to move your mouse cursor around. And then from that, it looks almost kind of like a little microphone, but it's a little blue switch byte. So that blue end that you might think is a microphone is actually a switch. So you would put that in your mouth to bite on the switch to essentially make your selection with your mouse. And then we have our big picture here with several of us. This is us in the Lending Library and Demo Center. Each of us are holding some of our new favorite technologies that have come in. So down at the bottom left corner, we have Hank Poor. He's contracting with us to help us do inventory and videos and trainings. And then we have Kenzie, who is right above him, so now in the top left corner, and she's actually holding a set of grabbers, which is, you know, just a very useful tool if you can't make, if you can't reach very easily, and it can grab stuff for you. She's actually an OT student that has been helping us out and volunteering to do some of our wonderful social media posts, so you've probably seen her team up with Hank in the past couple of weeks, so definitely make sure you're following us on our socials so you can get all that updated content. It's been great. Next, we have Elizabeth Stewart, and she's actually holding up a keyboard that has different types of keys on it. So instead of just a standard plain keyboard, that specific keyboard is one of our dyslexia keyboards. So the font is actually designed to be easier for people with dyslexia to read. And then next to Elizabeth is our director, Ashley McElroy, who's a big fan of cooking and baking and all things like that. So she was very excited to have some of our adaptive kitchen equipment come in. So she's got our adaptive cutting board, as well as a digital liquid measurement container. So it's instead of you having to try and read those little tiny lines, it's actually measuring it and providing auditory output to let you know when you've gotten to a certain level. And then that's me down at the bottom right there. And then I am holding the Logitech Adaptive Gaming Kit, but I'm also sitting in one of our new chairs. So I'm in the tandem chair. So instead of sitting back on a backrest, I'm actually kneeling on like a knee pad. So I don't have a back support. So it's more to help, engage my core and help with my posture a little bit. It's been a fun chair to have. So, and then down at the bottom, right, we have Nikisha Adams, and she is using her iPad for a communication while she's working with us to create a PowerPoint for some of our upcoming trainings. All right. So what is the Assistive Technology Act program? What does that mean? What is its purpose? We are federally funded through the 21st Century Technology Act. I am going to read through the actual verbiage that they've provided, because I thought it kind of wrapped it all up into one. And it says, to support state efforts to improve the provision of assistive technology to individuals with disabilities of all ages, including underrepresented populations, through comprehensive statewide programs of technology-related assistance designed to increase the availability of, funding for, access to, provision of, and education about assistive technology devices and assistive technology services. So really, we are here to let everybody in the state know about assistive technology, to be able to get their hands on assistive technology, to try out assistive technology, to have resources that if they need to purchase it, or just to better understand their role in helping somebody maybe that needs assistive technology, if there's something that they can do to facilitate that process. So really, we are your one-stop shop of assistive technology in the state of Alabama. So just a little bit more about accessing potential through assistive technology, or APTAT specifically. We are available to anyone in Alabama. So we are one of 56 programs throughout the states and territories of the United States. So we are specifically here to help Alabama. So anyone in Alabama, and that's going to include individuals with disabilities, their patients and caregivers, service providers, which could include health services, it could provide state agencies, schools, anybody's that are providing those services to somebody with a disability, we're able to assist them as well. And then lastly, companies, organizations that may be interested in assistive technology to benefit their employees, but also their customers. So really, anybody that you can think of, we are here to assist in their knowledge and acquisition of assistive technology. Now, we are housed under ADRS, which is the Alabama Department of Rehab Services. So when you look through the website, and you'll see us as one of those programs. However, you do not have to be enrolled as a consumer of ADRS to utilize our services specifically. So I know some people think, oh, well, do you have to already have a VR counselor? Do you have to be enrolled through CRS? You do not. The whole point of the Assistive Technology Act program is we want everybody to know about assistive technology, not just people who are already receiving the services. Because ultimately, when more people know about it and can have that as part of their environment and know how to accommodate for, everybody's going to benefit. So we really want to make sure everybody knows this is not just for people who are receiving services through ADRS. So now we're going to review over the programs and services that we provide here at APTAT. And one of the first ones we want to talk about are our trainings. So this picture on the right is actually from our participation in the very successful and very exciting AT Alabama conference that we helped run this summer. And in this picture, you see our director, Ashley McElroy, is introducing one of the presenters at this conference, Mercy World Wolverton, and she's actually doing a session on using 3D printing to make assistive technology products. So one of our great collaborations this past year, and we're very excited to look into AT Alabama 2024. So definitely be on the lookout for that one. But one of the other things that we do is our monthly webinars. These are designed to highlight a variety of assistive technology devices and accessibility topics to let you know more about the products that are out there, but also designed to help develop skills in learning about assistive technology and accessibility. We do have a list of upcoming trainings that you can click on through this presentation. I will make sure that we have a link as well in the YouTube descriptions. Now, I will say that this is tentative some months in advance. You know, we've got to make sure everybody's solidified and, you know, sometimes calendars change, but at least it gives you a feel for some of the upcoming trainings that we're going to be having. We're really excited about the next couple where we're really going to get to dive into specific software and products and talk about how they can be beneficial to people with disabilities. APTAT is also available and happy to tailor trainings specifically for your organizations, schools, and programs. So instead of just waiting for the monthly webinar, we are happy to have you call us up, schedule something specific for us to come out and visit with your teams on any type of assistive technology topic that you might have questions on. Next, we want to talk about technical assistance. So APTAT is available to provide extensive assistance to state or local agencies or other entities interested in improving assistive technology services in their organizations. And this is just a small sampling of people or organizations that might benefit from technical assistance. So it could be state and local education agencies, early intervention programs, adult service programs, hospitals and healthcare facilities, institutions of higher education, and businesses, nonprofits. Some examples might include, you know, maybe you want to have your HR team look at your process for job applications, you know, making sure that those are accessible, that you're making sure to make appropriate accommodations, not only to fill out forms, but what's your interview process look like, et cetera. Maybe you want to look at how are we providing accommodations that are being requested? What's our policy? Do we need to reorganize and rethink how we do that? It could be a variety of things that if you're really looking at how can we make sure that we are utilizing the tools that are available to us to make sure that we are getting the best out of not only our employees, but also making it a warm and inclusive, welcoming experience for consumers and customers. So, definitely give us a call. We'd love to see how we can help you. Next, we're going to talk about demonstrations. And these are things where if you need to know about a specific type of assistive technology. So maybe you want to know more about keyboards. You want to know more about assistive tech or AAC devices or alternative augmentative communication devices. The device demonstration is available for individuals to compare features and benefits of devices for the purpose of decision-making, right? So when I say keyboards, you know, there's at least 20 off the top of my head that I can think of that vary in, you know, size, you know, key type, purpose, you know, how it's designed a specific way. So, you know, you don't want to have to check out each individual keyboard. You may want to come in first, talk with us, have us go over some of those features and benefits of the different types of keyboards. Like, why would you want a mechanical keyboard versus a keyboard that maybe has a lower key profile? What's the difference between like just a standard keyboard and an ergonomic keyboard? Having the ability to kind of look at what's available first and talk through that process can help make assistive technology feel less daunting and help you kind of decide where your next steps are going to be. Currently, demonstrations are available at our Homewood office here in the Vocational Rehab office. And we do ask that demonstrations are scheduled by appointment. And you can do that by emailing us at aptat@rehab.com. www.alabama.gov. And the reason why we like to do that as opposed to just people randomly showing up is we really want to make sure that if you have a specific area or need, you know, some devices might take a little bit of time for us to set up to really have it fully functioning and for you to see the benefits of that. And some things we can't kind of whip up in 5 minutes. It might take us a little bit to, you know, clear some space out. So definitely, please try to make an appointment in advance. We are here 5 days a week. I'm sure we can help find some times for you. Next, we want to talk about our reuse program. And this is actually really exciting. This is one of my favorite things that we're able to do throughout the state. We have donated durable medical equipment that is available to the public at no cost. So, you know, think about walkers, think about bed rails, you know, even grab bars, things like that, that maybe, you know, some of us have had in our closet because, you know, a family member needed it for a little while, they no longer need it, no longer use it, and now it's just taking up space. Or maybe we need one, but, you know, those can be expensive, especially if you have other medical bills and things coming up. So really having the ability to just see if what I need is out there in the state and be able to grab that item for free, I think is just such an easy way for us to help each other out. So we do have five programs throughout the state. What happens is people donate their items to those centers specifically. Don't bring them here. We don't have the space. You're going to contact those demonstration or the reuse centers. Drop them off there. They will inspect them. They'll clean them. If there's, you know, maybe there's a bolt missing or a screw loose, they'll tighten those up, make them as shiny and new as possible, and then have them available for everyone else to come and collect what they need. So we have five centers. The one that is located in Birmingham is called the Remedy Center. In Huntsville, we have the Waste Not. In Mobile, it's called the We Share Project. In Dothan, it's the Real Project. And in Montgomery, it's the Care Project. And we have links for all of those organizations. It should take you to a website that gives you either contact information or a little bit more about where they're located at. And then we also have a PDF down at the bottom that will just list everyone there as well. You will want to contact them directly just because their inventory fluctuates day to day, right? Because if they're getting new stuff in and it's going out, it's going to change pretty frequently. So you may want to call them first to see if they have what you're looking for. Next, let's talk about our short-term device loan program. And this is, I think, one of our highlights, our biggest features of the APTAT services. This is the ability for devices to be checked out by you and borrowed for up to 30 days for free without cost. You know, there are several reasons why you might want to try out an assistive technology device from us. One could be for decision-making purposes. Maybe you are in a school system, you have a student that is part of an AT evaluation or in the consideration process, and you want to make some determinations of like what would be the best assistive technology to help that student with their particular need. Or, you know, just for any funding purposes, typically they want to have a record of we've tried this device out first here, you know, and you're going to work with your service provider on it. Or maybe you're just purchasing something out of pocket and you want to know if it's going to work before you spend money on it, right? Like some of these things can get a little costly, but also too, just if I don't have to buy something for like $100 or even $20 and realize it's not going to work for me and then the hassle of if I can return it or not, you know, come talk to us. We may already have that item. If we don't have that item, ask us if we've got it. And if we don't, we're always happy to make sure that we can get one as fast as possible in the inventory for you, because we want you to be able to feel comfortable in that decision making. Next is temporary accommodations, right? So sometimes we get injured or we're ill. We don't have our full capacity and functions that we normally do. And maybe we just need to borrow something for a little bit, right? So like maybe I'm healing from a rolled ankle or something like that. And maybe I need a grab bar for just, you know, just for 30 days while I'm letting my ankle heal, something towards that effect. We're a great resource. So that way you're not having to spend the money for it. You can just borrow it for that short amount of time. Maybe you need a loaner while your device is getting repaired. You know, we have communication devices or other types of equipment that might need to get replaced. But while you're waiting for that replacement to come in or to get repaired, we may be a good source for you to borrow a device. And then lastly, professional development. All types of service providers, it's best for us to know what's current and what's new, and technology changes in a split second, right? So this is a great way for you to stay current, stay up to date, but also to not just go, oh, I've heard of this, but to really try it out and see where the limitations are or where the benefits are. And so then that way you can help your consumers make more informed decisions when you're, you know, helping to make that determination of where do we want to try next in terms of assistive technology devices, because you'll have that knowledge about a particular product. And then you can see all of our inventory and to make requests to check those out at our website, which is al.atforall.com. And we'll actually talk about that a little bit later. Some additional services that we provide. APTAT, we are here to talk about assistive technology every day, all the time. So please contact us with any questions that you might have about assistive technology. That's one of the big things that we're here for. Maybe you want to seek advice or recommendations on different types of devices to look at or to try, or you know, what are we forgetting to look at, or which path do we need to choose? Maybe you want information on funding opportunities. Are there grants available? Are there places to go to find ways to get this device purchased? And then also just general AT knowledge. Maybe you want to understand a little bit more about how IDEA works in terms of assistive technology. If you're in the education system, maybe you want to understand how, you know, what's the best way to do an AT evaluation when I'm receiving services through the state. So really just, you know, any kind of AT question, we're here to help you answer that. And then coming soon, we're very excited, it's on its way. We are going to be developing an AT makerspace here in our demo center. We're really excited about this, as it will allow us to create and distribute low-cost AT equipment and modifications. So we're going to get a 3D printer in here. We'll have some other items and tools to help make those accommodations and modifications. So, you know, if it's something, you know, to be able to hand somebody assistive technology right then and there and not have to wait for something, not have to wait for something to get customized, we're just really excited to be able to have that type of service. All right, so I already mentioned it, but it's always worth to revisit this website over and over and over again because our inventory is changing daily. But this is our website where you can go to see all of the inventory that we have available for our loans and demonstrations. So this is al.atforall.com. And we'll actually show you some screenshots in just a little bit of the website itself. But when you go to the website, that's where you're going to see everything that we have available. As basically, once it comes in and as soon as we get it onto the website, it should be popping up pretty quick. So you'll also be able to see some information and some of the inventory for the reuse centers. Now, because the reuse centers inventory fluctuates so much, they may not be able to update specifics, but we do make sure that their contact information is there. So if nothing else, you can at least call them and find out if what you're looking for is available. All right. So I'm going to do screenshots first to show you how to create an account, because that's really what you want to do in the long run, to make requests to check out equipment for the loans. And then after I walk you through these screenshots, I'm actually going to pop into the website itself and show you what it looks like for a user to check out equipment. So in this left side of the screen, we have our main page, and you can see it says, Welcome to Alabama's AT for All. And the way to know you are at the right website is you are looking in this top left corner for our logo that features the state of Alabama. Now, if you just type in ATforall.com, that will take you to a different site, state's program. So there are several other states that are using the similar platform. So you want to make sure it's the AL.ATforall.com. And the way to check again is make sure you see that Alabama in the top left corner. So now that we're here at the screen, you can see right underneath that Alabama, you see a little list of items, and the very, very first one says log in or create account. So that's what we want to click on. And now over on the right side of our screen is another screenshot. And this is what it looks like after you've selected log in or create an account. So at the top, it's giving you that option to log in. We're looking for the bottom button that says select to create an account. All right, in our next screen, it's showing you the information that you'll be required to provide. So here it's saying request new account. It's going to require your first, your last name, your address, a phone number. And then on the bottom part, it's going to ask you for login information. So you'll need to provide an email and a password. And just a note that email address is the one that we will use to notify you of, you know, your loans or any changes, information regarding this account. So make sure it's an email you can access. Next, you're going to see the user agreement. Okay, so I wanted to actually show you what the website looks like after you have created your account and logged in. So the way you know that you are logged in and you are ready to check out equipment is we are at that main page, over to the left again, right underneath my Alabama logo. I'm going to actually see my username and login information, right? So I see my username or my name and then my email address. So that lets me know that I'm logged into the system. So now I'm just going to take a quick tour of the website. So here at the very top in the middle, it says, Welcome to Alabama's AT for All. Next, you will see some scrolling announcements, just giving you additional information, ways to contact us, letting us know about different things. If you feel like the scroll is going too fast, at the top right of that announcement block, there is three buttons that you can press. The middle one is a pause button. So you can actually pause it. It will stop. And then you'll be able to read through the announcement. Now, some of the announcements get cut off in the block, so you may need to scroll for more information. And then if you want to go to the next announcement, there's that button that goes to the right. Or if you want to backtrack, you can go to the one on the left. And that will let you scroll through the different announcements that way. Down below, you can see that you can find items by category. So if you just want to look for computer stuff, if you just want to look for gaming stuff, whatever it is specifically that you're looking for, you can start here. So I'm actually going to look at daily living. All right. So I've opened up the search results page, and it says the category at the top, it's letting me know daily living. And then if you notice underneath that, it says program. And it's saying all programs. And what that means is within the state, part of the services that we provide is other organizations can use this platform to house their own assistive technology inventory. So we actually have a school district that instead of creating a separate inventory system, they actually have their own inventory system as a program in here. We also have our reuse centers put their inventory in here. So you want to make sure you pick the right one so you know whose stuff you're looking at. So we're at program, and I'm just going to click on that where it says all programs, and I'm seeing a drop down button. So you see all of these different places are utilizing this platform. So we want to select the one at the very top. It says APTAT, or accessing potential through assistive technology. And now it's actually going to filter my results a little bit more. So now I'm still daily living. Now the program is the right one. Okay. Now, the next one below, it says all transaction types, so things that are available for loan versus demo. But really, you don't need to worry about that because you'll see that information as you're peeking through the items. And then you can just scroll through and see all of the different things that we've put under the category of activities of daily living. So, you know, we've got different types of grabbers, we've got kitchen aids like this baggy holder, button hooks, so a wide variety of things. But maybe I need something a little bit more specific that I'm looking for, right? So maybe I want to look for a zipper assistant, so like a zipper pull. So I'm just going to put zipper in the search results or in the search bar at the very top. So up at the very, very top above the search results, I just have this little search bar and I'm just going to put the word zipper in. And now I'm only going to see the things that are available that relate to zipper assistance. So the first two options, right, is a clear zipper pull, and then I have the zipper and button puller that are available. And then you'll see some other ones where you're like, well, I don't see zipper in the title or the name or the item name. And that's because you're going to see the word zipper somewhere else in the descriptions. So like the Salmon's Preston Deluxe Dressing Stick does refer to assisting with zippers. So it's going to be there in the description. So it's not just looking for the name, it's looking through the description itself. So if you're really not sure of like the name of a product, but if you know what it does or a feature of it, go ahead and just search it for it that way. That might help you find what you're looking for specifically. All right, so I really like this clear zipper pull. I think that's going to be the one I want. So I'm going to click add to cart. And then up in the very, very top right, so where that search bar was, now I'm going to go all the way to the right, I see a little shopping cart. And so I'm going to click on that shopping cart and it shows my items that are in the cart. And I'm going to go ahead and click that checkout button. And next, what you're going to see is why I want that specific item. So it's just a couple of questions. So the first one is asking about like, why are you checking this out? Is this for decision-making? You know, am I trying this out to make sure it's the one I want or that it's going to be helpful? Am I borrowing this because something else is on repair or I'm having a just as a temporary accommodation? Or again, am I using this as part of a training or maybe just to teach myself as part of my self professional development? Why do I need the zipper pull? So I'm going to put this in decision making. Maybe I want to try it for me. I don't have any additional comments here that I need to add, and then I'm going to click continue. And then it's just letting me know, make sure this is everything that you wanted, and then process the cart. Now, once you've processed it, we are going to get an email that lets us know that you've made that request. And then usually within a day or two, you should hear back from either myself or Tina or Ashley to verify that these were the items that you wanted. If you have any additional questions or needs, we just want to make sure that you're ready for that device when we send it to you. Okay. All right. So now the fun starts, right? We're going to talk about our assistive technology highlights, some of the things that have recently been added to the inventory that we're very, very excited about that we want to talk to you and let you know. So next is the fun part, right? We're going to talk about our assistive technology highlights, some of our additions to the inventory that we're very excited to share with you all. So this first one is going to actually be a video from Nikisha Adams. She did a video with us demonstrating several items. So you'll see all of those in action with Nikisha. She's going to review the weighted utensils, the candy corn proximity switch, and the PowerLink 4, the Dose Health System, and then the Easy Flex Stylist.
My name is Nikisha Adams. I play soccer at the Lakeshore Foundation, and I'm currently a program assistant for APTAT. In the past, I've done data entry at Red Mountain Parks and was the secretary at the Board of Education. I am currently working towards a career in public speaking. I was born with a disability called cerebral palsy. It affects the way I talk and walk. I am 49 years old. When I was growing up, there wasn't any assistive technology available. The closest thing I could find was a typewriter, so that is what I used in school. I couldn't write and I didn't want to have someone write for me, because the first thing that they would say is, "You didn't do the work yourself. Somebody did it for you," and I hated that. As times changed, you got to see the technology get better, and you got to see how technology catches up to the disability. A few years ago, I got my first talking device, an iPad with Proloquial 2 type. It has been great, because I can use it for work, communicating with other people, etc. This is why I'm so passionate about assistive technology, and I'm happy to be working for APTAT. To start us off easy, let me show you the weighted utensils we just ordered. Keyboard utensils are ergonomically designed with finger indentations for added grip comfort. Each utensil is balanced for easy-to-use weight distribution. As you put the utensils in your hand, the weight distribution is very different than regular utensils. As for me, once I put it in my hand, the weight of it didn't bother me. I just couldn't get it in my hand comfortably to eat with. This is a video of me using the weighted fork to eat cucumber slices. I am left-handed, so I have to use my right hand to get stable, and once I do that, I can use it safely.
Nikisha picks up a weighted fork. It looks like a standard metal utensil with a slightly larger or fatter handle with a little bit of a curvature to assist in grip. After using her opposite hand to adjust the positioning of the fork, she brings the bowl closer to her with the fork so she's able to secure a cucumber onto the fork, bringing it up to her mouth to safely eat the cucumber.
Next, let's look at some oldies but some goodies. The PowerLink is an environmental control unit that allows the student to operate small electrical appliances through switch access. You simply plug in the appliances and switches into the PowerLink, and the user can turn the devices on and off. This is a good option for when the appliance buttons are hard to access. I do want to note that devices with mechanical switches work the best, either a push button switch or a rotary dial. Devices like my fan with a digital on-off do not work. Let's watch how it works. In the video, I hover over the switch with my hand and it activates the device, which is a small fan.
Nikisha hovers her hand over the triangular shaped switch without touching it, which activates a small fan sitting on the table in front of her.
We also received a demo unit for the Dose Health Assistive Technology System for medication management and medical alerts. The Dose Flip is a smart pill box that can be programmed for medication reminders using the app. At the scheduled time, it will sound an alarm and flashlight. The cover rotates to open the scheduled dosage slot. To dispense, the individual simply flips the pill box over into their hand or a cup and takes the medication. Dose Flip will continue to remind the individual if it does not sense that the medication has been retrieved, and can let caregivers know via the phone notifications if medication has not been taken. Our kit also includes the adaptive flipper, which is a stand that holds the Dose Flip and allows the user to rotate the container more easily. We also have the refilling disc, which clips onto the tray of the Dose Flip to expand the filling surface. It also makes it easier to double check medications as they are filled. Let's watch as I try it out. In the video, I start out by using the refilling disc to fill up the pill box.
A large plastic divided tray is placed on top of the pill box with each section lining up with the pill box. Nikisha is able to place the pills onto that tray and then push them into the desired slots of the pill box. The device is activating to tell us that it is ready to take medication.
We then place the pill box into the adaptive flipper, and when the alarm sounds, the pill box rotates to open the slot. I can then flip the box, and it drops the medication into the metal cup below. They also provided a sliding tray that I can use to pull the metal cup closer to me.
Nikisha is able to flip the pill box and then pull the medication cup using the small plastic tray that has a handle.
The Easy Flex stylus is a versatile and adjustable stylus that allows user to position it in just about any position, between fingers, above the hand, under the hand, around the wrist. Whatever works best for them.
A stylist with attached to lock line is wrapped around Nikisha's wrist as she uses it.
I like the way this stylus felt when using it because it felt like I had more support with the way it wraps around the wrist. I didn't have to worry about dropping. But it is difficult to put on without assistance, which is a downside. Also, it's $115, which seems a little ridiculous since it's just made with lock line and a stylus tip.
Thank you, Nikisha, for those wonderful, wonderful demonstrations. We hope to have more of those up soon. Next is Hank Poor and Mackenzie Williams. And as I mentioned before, they have been doing quite a lot of work for our social media feeds, recording some demonstrations of products that have been coming in. And Mackenzie was nice enough to let me get some sneak peeks of some items that they recorded, but aren't scheduled to go out just yet. So premiere videos here for us. And these videos will be demonstrating the Obi feeding robot, as well as the GE Smart Microwave and the Cool Hand Grip.
A black tray is placed on top with four quadrants, followed by the actual food tray that contains lips to help with scooping. The two switches are plugged into the device, one for rotating the tray, the next for the robot to bring the food to you. A packet of fruit snacks are open and placed into one of the wells of the four quadrant tray. A spoon is attached to the articulating arm and secured into position. The device is turned on, and the robot arm turns, makes a bow to indicate that it is ready. The robot is scooping the gummy bears into the spoon and then bringing it up to the person using it. In this video, Hank is activating the switches using his feet that are not seen and bringing the robot arm up to Mackenzie's mouth so she can eat fruit snacks. A frozen dinner is opened and placed onto a plate. The plastic is removed. The microwave is being opened, and the plate with the dinner is placed inside. Using an iPad app, you scan the barcode on the frozen dinner box, and instructions for cooking appear. They are sent to the microwave, and you press start on the microwave. After cooking is completed, open the microwave. Now you see the Cool Hand Grip, which is a plastic handle with three prongs designed to grasp the lip of a plate so you do not have to touch them.
All right. So next, for those that joined us on Tuesday, we had a lovely time showing you around our demonstration center and lending library to see all the fabulous things that we've added. And we did that with our friend over here, the meeting owl. You can't quite see it. Let me bring it up for you. So this is the meeting owl, and we're actually going to do another tour again very, very soon. Everybody really enjoyed being able to see things happening live in person in action. So instead of me trying to run around the room and do it all by myself, I'm just going to slowly pan with my camera here to let you see the room. But we also just want to let you know, we're going to be doing another live demo with the meeting owl. So you get that really cool 360 view, seeing all the different devices close up and in action. All right. So as we wrap up, we do appreciate your feedback. We do have a Survey Monkey survey for you to fill out, and we truly, truly appreciate it. This really helps us develop these trainings and services and programs and lets us know what you need, right? We're not here to serve our own purposes. As much as I love specific types of assistive technology, I always want to make sure we're suiting the needs of what people actually want to learn about or know about or get their hands on. So please fill out the survey. It helps us a lot. It is a Survey Monkey survey. So it will be www.surveymonkey.com/r/ and then all uppercase NYHV, the number 6, the number 5, and then a capital Q. And we will have, again, that link in the YouTube description. Just to let you know, we're going to keep these rolling every month. This coming month in November, we're going to talk with Cifable, which is a really fascinating software product that we can't wait for you to see in action. This is a software product that allows you to use whatever type of preferred input you have to, you know, control your computer, to control an app, to control different devices. So if you're somebody who can use voice commands or you want to use facial gestures, maybe you have a virtual button that you're able to use or some kind of existing hardware, Cifable lets you turn all those types of access points into ways to control the technology the way you want to. So we do have a link for you to register through Zoom, and that will be November 28th at 4 p.m. And we'll talk with the gang from Cifable. And so that registration link is bit.ly/3, a lowercase r, then all capital letters XEN, the number 9, and then a capital S. All right. Thank you all for joining us. We are at the end of this webinar session. Please, please contact us. The best way to do that is through our email. That is APTAT@rehab.alabama.gov. We also have links for our LinkedIn, our Facebook, and our YouTube. If you search under accessing potential through assistive technology, in those platforms, we should pop right up. But we also have links here in the slides. So thank you again, everyone, and we'll see you soon.